Street. We are broadcasting live tonight from Washington, D.C. I'm your host, Cassandra Archer, a.k.a. the Divine Diva of Comedy. Thank you for tuning in tonight. We have a great show. You better tune in to this Vessel Radio. See, this is a wonderful thing, man.
When I open these 2 eyes, the world has not been kind to me. It's not pleasing to me. The world no longer appeals to me.
Tune in every Tuesday right here at Vessel Radio. 7 o'clock. Don't be late, you know.
Majority of the males in my family are in jail to this day.
Wow. And it's brother Shazan and Preston. My God. Man, you can't tell me say they're not good people.
Says, hello, my name is D. My mother's currently in the hospital at this present time in ICU due to a blood clot in her heart.
For 5 straight weeks, I went to 5 straight funerals. I just lost a child.
I just received news today that I may not be able to carry a pregnancy to full term.
Tune into Vessel Radio every Tuesday. Eh? You hear what I'm saying? Forgive Tommy Ferguson. Duh, why? I really didn't want to. So when he gave me an apology, I had to accept his apology. But really, I wanted to give him like a knuckle sandwich or something. Just pop. But that's not nice. That's not nice at all. So we want to avoid that. So I forgave Tommy Ferguson. And then the next day, he gave me some of his ice cream from the ice cream truck. So never quit. But it's very important today because if you don't know that almost 20% of high school kids are found to be bullies or to be bullied. And sometimes it can end up in a very bad situation. And we don't want to have anybody go to the hospital or get locked up or anything like that. But they can lock up Tommy Ferguson. They can't actually. Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say that. So, okay, Vessels, we're here. It's Tuesday night at 7 o'clock every Tuesday. Go Vessel Radio!
Thank you so much, Melissa. It's a pleasure having you back as always. I know it's a little late. Hopefully you had an opportunity to finish your homework. But anyway, Vessels, thank you once again for tuning in. My name is Shazan. I am so excited to be here with you this Tuesday. For those of you tuning in for the very first time, be sure to follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Vessel Radio. You can also send us an email to vesselradio@gmail.com. And of course, we are looking forward to hearing from you this evening. And you can definitely give us a call or text to 276-D1-VESSEL. That is 276-318-3773. As Melissa is here with us today, I thought it would be fitting for us to go ahead and read from the book of Matthew, and that is chapter 18. And I'm going to be reading from verses 1 through 5. And it reads, "At that time, the disciples came to Jesus saying, 'Who then is greatest in the kingdom of heaven?' Then Jesus called a little child to him, set him in the midst, and said, 'Assuredly, I say to you, unless you are converted and become as little children, you will by no means enter the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, whoever humbles himself as this little child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Whoever receives one little child like this in my name receives me.'" So that was found, ladies and gentlemen, from the book of Matthew, again, chapter 18, verses 1 through 5. And as Melissa indicated, we have some very special guests that'll be joining us shortly. And before we get to that, though, wanted to go ahead and give you Shazan's song of the day, and that is "The Greatest Love of All" by Whitney Houston.
Never to walk in any
my wonderful co-host, my sister Arnell, and we have two wonderful guests. This is going to be a great show. If your friends aren't tuned in, you need to text somebody right now and tell them to get on board and get on line right now so that they can find out all about this wonderful, important information that we have, the subject of bullying. So tonight, our guests are actually students and speaking from the heart and from personal experience. To my right is this wonderful young lady, Bria. She's currently in the seventh grade, attending Baltimore International Academy, which is elementary and middle school. She's been working, going to this school since second grade, and her primary study language is Russian, which is awesome. The second language is French. That's just amazing. Okay, and a year ago, Bria basically witnessed some of her classmates being bullied. So they formed an anti-bullying club called Creative Positive Change, CPC. And this is to help other students deal with their issues of being bullied in school. They found that students were more open to talking to teachers and their guidance counselors. So Creative Positive Change is a supportive group, and they're on a mission to help find a solution towards the cause of bullying. And Arnell, tell us a little bit about Damali.
Okay, and to my left, I have Miss Damali Morgan Bean. She hails from the beautiful state of Georgia. Born and raised for most of her life in a suburb of Atlanta, Georgia, Molly, as she is affectionately known, gleans much of her southern charm, wit, and delight from that which she came. From the time of her arrival on this earth, Molly has pierced the hearts of so many with her sweet spirit, exuberant sense of humor, and uncalculated wit. Wow. From a very early age, she has demonstrated and professed a profound love for God, His Word, and His statutes. It is not uncommon to find Damali buried in the Word of God, and at the age of 11, she shared with family that she would like to pursue a life in complete dedication to God and go into ministry. She said that at the age of 11.
Amen.
She truly loves the Lord and wants to share the message of His love and salvation with the world as a missionary. In addition to having a heart for God, she excels exceptionally well in school, exhibits excellent behavior. She plays the drums. Mm. She loves to build with her Legos. She's heavily involved with the drama ministry at church. And she has experienced some bullying. And so every day she just tries to make a difference through her own life example and trying to create a positive example for people.
Wow. Wow. Okay, let's give it up for these two wonderful young ladies. Awesome. Strong young black women up on Vessel Radio, okay? And another thing we don't know about Damali is...
she is my daughter.
Beautiful young lady, beautiful. So we're happy to have you ladies here. And very excited. I'm sure your peers will be very encouraged by this. The group, Bria, you have the group that you started yourself.
My teacher came to me and said that it was a problem with bullying in our school. And I went to my friends who I thought would be interested, and they said that would be a good idea. So we just went from there.
So it was your idea or your teacher's idea?
My teacher said that it would be a good idea if we had a club to help people vent out and tell us what their problems are and we can help them. So I just told my friends and they said that would be a good idea.
So were you on student council or something like that?
No.
Or were you in, what do they call, peer mediation group?
No.
Okay, so why did she pick you out to start this?
I think she thinks I really have care for people that I knew for a long time, and she thought it would be a good idea for me to start it.
Okay. Awesome. So who created the name?
Our whole group, we meted one day, and we were looking on the internet, and it was a video about bullying, and it said Create Positive Change, so we thought that would be a good name for our group.
Okay, phrase in the information that you read. That was awesome. So, Damali, do you guys have any program like this at your school?
No.
No? So, hearing what Bria, her school has created, do you think that your school would be interested in doing something like that?
Yes, they would.
Okay. And what grade are you in again?
I'm in sixth grade.
Sixth grade. So, for both of you ladies, okay, Bria first and then Damali, you can answer. Have either of you been bullied before?
No, I have not been bullied before.
No?
I have.
You have been bullied?
Yes.
So tell us about that experience, not using any names, but just tell us what happened.
Okay. So, started this year, I had some people that I thought were my friends, and then the situation came up, and I wasn't there to go to, like, the guidance counselor could talk with us. I wasn't there because it was, like, a two-hour delay, so my mom said I could stay home, and when I came the next day, they all thought I was fake and stuff, and then they said I was fake because I wasn't there, and then that's when they started.
Because you weren't involved in a situation.
Yeah.
So wow. They started calling you names and talking about you.
Yeah, spreading rumors.
How did that make you feel?
I mean, it made me feel bad at first, bad about myself, but then I was like, then I listened, like, my favorite artist is Lecrae, and then okay. I listened to him, and then I was listening to his song Tell the World, and he said, "What is a man that you're mindful of him, and what do I have to deserve this loving?" So I was like, I don't have anything to fear, because... you know, I have
praise
Jesus.
God. Praise God. Awesome. So, if you knew that this situation was happening at your school and you're friends at Damali at mm-hmm. your school, what would you do with, how would you implement your program with helping Bria?
Well, I would first let her come to the meetings, and I would let her just say what she feels, and then we would try to encourage her that she shouldn't feel bad about herself, and she should feel good about herself because she knows that she's really not what they say she's are. They're just making you feel bad because they feel bad about themselves.
I know that's right. I do that. So, how did your school handle this, or what did you guys decide to do?
Well, it kind of died down. Like, I went to the principal about it, and she told me some people already apologized to me, and then I went and told her about the other people that were still, you know, saying stuff about me and making fun of me, and she looked me in my eyes, and she said, like, what am I supposed to do about it?
Okay.
That was her response.
And how do you feel that she should have, what do you think that she should have done?
I think she should have took it more seriously, because people, like, they do stuff to themselves that they shouldn't be doing and stuff like that. So she should have took it more seriously.
When you say people do things to themselves that they shouldn't do, what do you mean?
They do, like, self-harm, mm-hmm. or they want to take their own life and stuff like that, which isn't a good thing.
Yeah. Wow.
Do you think that people are afraid? So Bria, for your group, do you find that some of the people that come, are they afraid to tell someone what's going on? Do they feel like it makes them look weak, or, you know?
Well, I have somebody that joined my group, and she was, you could tell that she was afraid to tell because she thought we were going to go to the person and directly say it to them. So you could tell that she was a little bit scared mm-hmm. because she thought she was going to get hurt by the person. Mm-hmm. But I think anybody would be scared to tell anybody because you think you're going to get come back to and they're going to bully you more.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, scared of that.
Yeah.
That response coming back from, you know, it's just going to keep on going around if you keep on talking and going back. And sometimes when people are afraid of the response or what's going to happen, they're embarrassed. First of all, after they bully someone, they become embarrassed and ashamed. So they're going to rebel mm-hmm. with violence or being more upset or just cause more commotion. I commend you young ladies because you're stepping out and trying to make a difference and help someone, and Damali, I'm so proud that you didn't retaliate, because you could have went up there and said, "I'm not fake," and you could have started a fight or anything because yeah. of your feelings. But I heard you say, you quoted a scripture from your favorite singer. Do you think you being centered and you knowing Jesus helped you with this situation?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
So do you think you would encourage other kids?
Yes, because some people, because some people, they don't know who Christ is and they don't have that personal relationship. So they believe that, okay, no one here wants me, but it's like, you don't, that's the problem. Like, Jesus wants you. You just have to open your heart up to him and accept him as your savior and you will get salvation. Same thing, like, yeah, just...
What would you say to the person that is the actual bullier, the one that's bullying? What is the message that needs to get across to that person of how they make people feel and what they're doing?
What I say, I ask them questions. I ask them, like, okay, so you have this on your record, like, if you have children and they ask you, how was your high school life like? And you can't just come out and say, oh, I was a bully. I picked on this kid. I threw him in a locker. Like, how will your kids look up to you? Like, how will your kids look at you? And then my other question will be, is your self-esteem that low that you have to pick on somebody else so that you can gain self-confidence and you feel better about yourself by tearing somebody else down so you can feel better on the inside when eternally? It's not about externally, because a lot of these bullies, externally, they look good. They have all the new shoes, but internally, they're just broken pieces.
And so this girl is on fire! You are tuning into Wrestle Radio. I'm getting text messages. We are at 276-318-3773. These young ladies, yes. I mean, awesome. They are on a roll. I mean, Christ-centered and know what they're talking about and starting your own foundation. This is wonderful. Please send us, hit us up at Vessel Radio. Craig, Shazan, can you believe this?
Call me by my government name. You know, letting people know who I am. Anyway, listen, we are so excited to have you both, Damali and Bria, with us. Wow. You are two beautiful young ladies that clearly have Christ in your life. And what I want to know is, at what age did you receive Christ? Both of you.
I got baptized last year, April 11th, and I was 12.
Awesome. I was 10, and I got baptized, and that'll be 2013.
Awesome. So, Bria, being baptized, and you know Christ, and he's your Savior, how would you, or are you allowed to bring Christ into your foundation? Does your teacher allow you to speak of Jesus?
She lets us speak of Jesus. We were just having a conversation about Easter, and she was sharing about how Jesus came back and he showed Thomas that he was God's son and he was the king. And yeah, she told me stuff I did not know.
A lot of the kids that are bullies, do you think they know Christ?
I think some of them do, but they're scared to, like, I think their friends don't necessarily focus on Jesus, so they're scared to open up to Jesus about them because they don't want to get made fun of. But it's not, Jesus is nothing to be scared to admit that you're opening up to him. He's going to help you get through what you need to get through, so...
Some kids are actually lukewarm Christians. Like, they're not wholeheartedly dedicated to Christ. Because if they were, then you would have no problem, like, saying that he was your Savior. You know, it says, deny me in front of these people. I would deny you in front of my Father at the gates of heaven.
I have a question for you ladies. Because it is clear and it's obvious that you two both love the Lord.
Amen.
But I know that you're surrounded by your peers. Do you ever experience any type of peer pressure? What are some of the things that you all experience that maybe you think us adults, we don't understand or we don't quite know? Just kind of share that with us.
I think peer pressure is hard not to get into because it's like the bullies there. They think they're cool and people think they're cool and you have to look up to them, but they're nothing compared to you because you're not doing the stuff they're doing. Because if peer pressure is, everybody wants to be in the in crowd.
Okay. Wow. Okay, these women, I'm telling you, I wish that I was that. outgoing and smart right. and, you know, obedient
yes,
at their
obedient.
Age. I am just so excited. We are here at Vessel Radio. We're going to take a quick break, but we'll be right back, okay? Because I'm learning something today. Amen.
Welcome back, everyone, to The Vessel. We are so excited to have our beautiful young guest with us joining us this evening. But before we continue, we actually had a caller who wanted to make a comment. Tori, are you there?
I'm here. Yes,
let
I
me,
am.
Let me turn up the volume just a little bit, Tori. All right. Okay. Can you hear us, Tori?
I can hear you.
All right. Well, we thank you. Tori, what was your comment?
I just want to commend the young ladies for coming out and speaking out about Christ in their life, and that many others are probably listening, including their peers. So that's a plus in itself that you're speaking out.
I think and I recognize their voice.
Because Christ is love, and you all are examples of that.
Yes. Amen. I think I recognize their voice. Is that my big sister?
Yes.
Hi, Tori. She's trying to give an alias.
Yes, it is,
Bruce. That is Torlanda. Hi,
you know,
sweetheart.
I had to comment that they're doing a wonderful, you all are doing a wonderful job there.
Thank you. Yes, they are wonderful.
Yes. And this needs to be, you know,
my question would be, do you think that this is going to be encouraging to others that hear you? And even when you think they aren't listening, that do you think that that's still being encouraging to them? And I'm going to hang up.
thank you so much. So, Damali?
It can be encouraging. It's like it depends on what you want to do with it. Okay. Like I can talk all day, but it's a matter of you wanting to pay attention and listen and grow in Christ.
Okay, how old are you again?
11.
Okay, Bria.
I think they're listening. And they know we're right because I don't think they're going to change because they're still scared to change. But I think they should because all the words that we're saying, they have to want it for themselves. We're not going to keep making them want it. They have to want it for themselves.
Very good. Wow, wonderful. Very good. So the CPC, which is Create Positive Change. Create Positive Change Program. And this is actually at your school now. Mm-hmm. It's an anti-bullying club. And there are 7 girls from the school. Are you going to invite boys?
The thing about the boys in our school, they're like what I'm saying. They're afraid to be with people like us.
Okay.
Because they think they're going to lose their friends.
Okay, wow. So let the girls okay. handle it, okay? Seven girls. So the girls are from 6th to 7th grade, mm-hmm. and they're all in a Russian class. So you can reach all over. I heard that you went to Towson University. What happened at Towson?
It was a Ray Rice rally, but we were basically the only student group there. So we also sold bracelets, and we gave out brochures, and we also had a sign-up sheet, and we're also reaching out to two people who signed up on the sheet, and we raised money to go to different conferences and schools to speak out to them.
Okay, teachers, educators, schools, universities, these children are reaching out. They're looking for sponsorship to go visit other schools, universities, and get the word out about Create Positive Change, the anti-bullying club. And this will be great to have in elementary school. I mean, it has to start from the source.
It has to
pre-K,
start.
Pre-K, because I know some bad little kids. Y'all saw Melissa in here acting up. She's on.
Oh, man. Well, listen, these young ladies clearly have the word of God in them, so I'm very proud to see that. Wanted to know from the two of you, what is one of your favorite scriptures?
Okay. I have many. My favorite one is 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 55-56. Oh, death, where is your sting? And oh, death, where is your victory? And then I have another one, but I don't know the chapter or the verse, but it says, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil.
Psalms
23.
Yeah. So why the first scripture, say it again, oh, death, here.
Oh, death, where is your sting? Oh, death, where is your victory?
Why did you pick that?
I picked that because most people, with bullying, there comes suicide, and if you know Jesus, number one, that's a sin you can't be forgiven of, and that's one sin you can't be forgiven of, and he has a greater purpose for you than this. And also, everyone's life is gonna end, but if you know Christ, you shouldn't be afraid, because your flesh may be 6 feet under, but your soul is high, is so high, it's with Jesus.
You have
Psalms 82:4. It's rescue the weak and the needy from the hands of the wicked. So I picked it because it goes back to the paragraph I wrote about bullying. It goes back to they only do it because they're either not being shown enough attention and they don't feel good about themselves.
Wow, that's awesome. You know, bullying goes into a lot of things, and as you get older, it can, you know, some people just don't stop. And if you know what domestic violence is, obviously, if you read about bullying, and I was a victim of domestic violence, and the person that abused me was bullied and victimized as a child. So it starts when you're young. So if you learn when you're young, you won't grow up to be a violent person. So I think that is very important. Mm-hmm. The young, I mean, I know you young ladies are in junior high school now, but you're older than the elementary school kids, so you may want to be able to find a way that you can speak at some elementary school so you can encourage the young kids to let them know that they don't have to be bullies and to find a good positive way. I've seen a few cartoons that talk about anti-bullying, so we're trying to get the word around.
Definitely. It really is an issue.
Yes.
From elementary school all the way to high school. And even adults experience bullying in some way, shape, or form.
Yes.
So it is very important that we get the message out how harmful and the effects of bullying. So I commend you for the program that you started. And Damali, do you think that maybe you would want to do something like that at your school?
I would like to, but, you know, school I'm at.
Well, but I think that if Bria got an opportunity to speak at an elementary school or another school, Damali, would you go to be a speaker? Because you have good backup information and you're grounded with, spiritually.
to support her in this. Mm-hmm. So maybe you guys can pair up, and your seven girls, maybe you can find seven girls to group up. That would be a good thing, huh?
Yeah.
You had another question, Shazan?
Well, actually, this is more of a comment. For those of you who are just tuning in with us, do note that we are being broadcasted all over the world, all 50 states and 135 countries, one of which I believe is Russia. And from what I understand, Bria has actually been studying Russian and might have something to say to all of our Russian viewers.
Знаю, що це право не означає много, якщо ви не делаєте то, що правильно. So it means knowing what is right does not mean much if you do not do what is right.
Awesome. That is awesome. So you should make a slogan for your anti-bullying program. So you need to make up a slogan that you can say in English and in Russian.
In Russian, that would be great.
Yeah, that would be great. I'm excited. Shout out to the Baltimore Academy, Mrs. Smith, for helping Bria and her friends start this wonderful program. This is awesome, and I want to be a part of this. I'm just excited because these young ladies are on fire.
Right.
We're going to take a quick commercial break, and we will be right back.
The blackness. Keep on.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Vessel Ministry Over Industry. We are so grateful to have you guys tuning in. If you are just joining us, please feel free to send us a text message or call at 276-D1-VESSEL. That's 276-318-3773. We are definitely looking forward to hearing from you also via email. You can reach us at vesselradio@gmail.com. Also, be sure to follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Vessel Radio. Speaking of text messages, we did receive an incredible text, and it reads, "Fantastic show. Blessings to Vessel Radio for providing a platform for young people to speak of their faith and address the issues they deal with." Mm-hmm. So if you're just tuning in, I'm going to turn the microphone and the camera back over to our host, our co-host, and our special guest, Damali and Bria.
Awesome. Awesome. I mean, these young ladies are on a mission. They have their knowledge together. They have their facts together. And I'm looking forward to seeing them. I mean, we could probably do this annually just to see how far along they've come.
Absolutely.
Yes. And bullying doesn't stop just at verbal. Talk about some other bullying that you've witnessed. What's something that you've seen? Or
I haven't seen people like... I've seen videos of people getting physical, but as far as in person, I've never seen anybody get pushed or hit or anything.
And Bria, have you ever witnessed bullying?
I have witnessed two situations of bullying. My best friend's brother has gotten bullied before and on school campus in front of administration, and the second one is my friend. She got teased in front of a whole group of people.
Wow, and that's sad. You had a question, Arnell?
I just wanted to say something to you ladies. I know that youth, including you two, that you all deal with a lot, whether it's bullying or peer pressure. And one of the other things is probably the influence of media, from music to the violent video games to what's on television. Can you guys talk a little bit about, you want to share how you've seen that impact individuals?
Yes, because...
Speak up, honey.
Now that I know more about Christ, I see... Because I used to listen to that type of music and stuff, but it's just not feeling at all. And I've seen, and now these songs, they're basically based off of the seven deadly sins, in my opinion.
Go ahead.
And what are those?
I only know, I know pride is a big one. Okay. And they're so conceited. It's all about me and my money. And I, like, people just listen to the beat, but if you listen to the lyrics, like, for example, I'm not gonna say any names, but some rappers, like, since when did killing people become popular?
Mm-hmm. And you're right. And do you guys think that also influences when you have the video games where it's nothing to kill someone, or the music is talking about, you know, your money and all different things? Do you see some of the people you know trying to emulate that or act out that?
Yes. First, I feel like when rappers are talking about females, the way they talk about females, that's a sign of bullying too.
They call females
out their names. Mm-hmm. They say certain stuff about females, and all females don't represent themselves that way. So I feel like them calling out females like that, that's disrespectful and that's bullying. Right. And then the second thing, it can impact some people, because if you're sitting in front of a game that serves violence, you're going to start to think you're like that, because video games grudge you into what they're doing. So you, if you play a video game for a certain amount of time, you're gonna start thinking you're one of the people in the video game.
Right.
A comment with that, like, they have this, I don't know if you heard of it, but along with, you know, women, they have the sausage movement, and it's when they go around and they take turns and they say stuff. And I've seen girls do it, and it's like they're degrading themselves of what they say. And even beside that, they have like these music videos. It's where women are portraying themselves as, you know, this type of person. It's like we can be so much better, and then they wonder why some people look down on us. It's because my thing is, if you want to be part, like, because the big thing now is getting rid of, like, the N-word. If you want to be part of, if you want the solution, then don't be part of the problem.
Right, exactly. Right. And the N-word is definitely bullying. That's verbal abuse, and That's an ugly thing.
So it's important for you all, and I think you guys have it, but for your peers, as you're spreading the message, a lot of times through the music and the video games, it may seem innocent, but there's a message that's really being pushed. So it's important, if you see your friends doing that, or, you know, engaging in that, kind of enlighten them and let them know, hey, you know, like you said, you're not a piece of meat or trash or whatever.
Sausage.
Like, what does your shirt say, Damali?
I am worth the wait.
Amen. I am worth the wait.
Amen. Right. I raised three boys. I have three sons, and I can remember when they were young. And I actually enjoyed a cartoon, but it was the Ninja Turtles kicking and you know, and the next thing you know, they kicking each other and swatting and everything. And I had to teach them, you know, it's just pretend. It's a cartoon. You don't actually hit each other. Right. So it starts from when you're young. Most definitely, anti-bullying projects need to be in elementary school, from nursery school, you know, all the way up. And we have to influence the boys. So, Bria, I'm challenging you to find a way that we can influence the boys to join and let them know, you know, they're not going to be punks or, you know, soft if they join an anti-bullying group. You know, it'll actually make them look more handsome or stand out.
And, oh.
Okay, go ahead.
Real quick, another thing I want to say to the parents, because a lot of parents are sending their kids to school and they don't know that their child is the bully.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
So we have to be mindful of what we're allowing our children to watch, what we're allowing them to listen to, the video games that they're playing. That's for the parents, because the parents are like, oh, not my baby. Yeah. And your baby is the one beating everybody up. So just be mindful of that, parents.
And young ladies, you can be flowers. These beautiful young ladies, you don't see them carrying B-word badges, and they're not half naked. You can be a flower and positive and strong and beautiful. You can do this.
Yes.
Shazan?
Definitely. You know, I'm just so excited to have these beautiful young ladies with us this evening. You know, the Word of God says in Proverbs 22, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he's old, he will not depart from it. So clearly, shout out to the parents who are also bringing up our children in the Word of God. Just wanted to also say we are receiving emails and text messages. Shout out to you, Keith Solomon, who wrote in to us, I am loving tonight's show. It is refreshing to see young people with a heart for Jesus Christ. This is Keith Solomon from Tampa, Florida. So we have Florida tuning in with us. Thank you again for joining us. And
hopefully
each and every one of you viewing this show is being blessed. But right now, my question is not to our beautiful young ladies, but to our beautiful older ladies. Have either two of you been bullied before when you were younger?
Woo! Yes! Well, I can remember in first grade that I was a bully because this kid used to eat paste, and I used to be like,
who knew?
Boy, if you keep eating paste, you're going to die. So every time I would see him eating paste, I would shake him. So I didn't realize I was being a bully, but yes.
Oh, no.
Actually, in high school, I went to Uptown Northwest Coolidge. I went to Coolidge High School. There was a bully. Everybody was afraid of this girl. Nobody liked her. Nobody wanted to talk to her. So one day, she hit me in my back of my head when I walked by. When I turned around, I was so scared that the fear that was in me allowed me to wail on this girl so bad. I tore her down, and the next day, everybody wanted to be my friend. So that was a bad...
the fear.
Right. Sometimes, you know, unfortunately, that's what happens to bullies, because when you're bullying somebody, you don't know what that kid is going to kirk out and do.
Right.
Unfortunately, some kids shut down and commit suicide, or they lash out, they're depressed. But I don't know where that strength came from. And I mean, I wailed on this girl so bad that I cried. But yes, Southeast. No, that's for Anthony eating paste in Southeast. But yes, I have found myself in small instances being a bully, but in other instances, I have been bullied before. And it was very upsetting. It was a very upsetting situation.
I did have
a situation. Don't try to act like you was a flower.
I was. No, you know what? I the same situation, sort of, kind of. Young lady in third grade. I want to say her name so bad, but I'm not. I ain't going to say it.
Right.
But
she used, names?
No. She said, do I remember names?
It was 80 years ago, Mom.
Ha, ha, ha. Yes, I do remember her name, but same thing. She used to always pick on people, fight people, yeah. And one day she picked on me, and we...
Gave it to her.
Yes. And see, when we were fighting, the way you knew you won a fight was who got down first.
Yes.
Who,
so yes.
I won that fight. Okay. Oh, wait a minute. I don't know. Should we be glorifying that? Wait a minute. No. Don't do that, y'all.
Okay, no, but I think it's a lesson. Because you're a bully, don't think that you won't get it. I mean, unfortunately, let's be real. A lot of kids, that's what happens. That's where the fights come in, because they provoke these, you know, kids. And I was a nerd. So, you know.
And pray for them. Right. We're going to finish that off with prayer.
Just like,
pray
for them.
Just like Melissa. I was a little nerd. I was a little geek. And I think that's why I got picked on. And unfortunately, it turned sour for the bully. So you bullies just need to stop. Give it up. Because, and I didn't want to retaliate, because, you know, I was a girl after that. It was like, yeah. Uh-huh. And I was like, no, we're not going there. You know, I didn't, mm-hmm. I would have had to fight the whole school. We're not going
right.
there.
So what
I think it's wonderful. I commend Bria and Damali for doing what you're doing. And yes. If you see someone that's close to you, a friend or something, and you know they're about to get into a fight or something, just pull them to the side and say, hey, it's not worth it. Mm-hmm. You know, speak peace over them and let them know that, you know, they don't have to go that route. I think that a lot of kids will soon turn over to not being, you know, to being an anti-bully supporter because of the way these kids are committing suicide and running away and the depression. Young kid, 9 years old, you on antidepressants? It's sad. It's really sad. And this social bullying, turn your laptop off. Turn the phone. Defriend the person. Right. You can get away from this stuff,
kids.
That's
another thing.
Talk to somebody. Mm-hmm. You know, just talking will help.
I'm glad you said that. The social media piece.
Yes.
That is another way that people are bullied. And not just children. I see grown-ups.
Yes.
On the exchanging words and, you know, talking about a person.
Yeah.
So that, be mindful of that too, you know. And again, parents, monitor your children and their social
That's
media,
right.
what
be
they're doing.
Be all up in this stuff. You have to. Be okay. nosy. Be real nosy. So, okay. So you guys were a wonderful guest. I really enjoyed you guys. So I like to have fun. We did get to laugh. So I'm going to ask you a crazy question now, okay? Okay. Damali put her head down. Okay, Damali. Okay, this question for both of you guys. Both of you guys. If you could... if you can be a cartoon character, who would you be and why? You got to think. You got to concentrate.
Wait.
So hard for an 11-year-old.
It's hard because I don't really watch TV.
You don't
like
watch
that.
TV?
I don't. There's too much going on.
You watch TV?
I don't watch cartoons then.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you could paint your hair, if you can color your hair, what color would it be and why?
Wait a minute.
Like, Mom, can I dye my hair, Mom?
Right. You don't want to dye your hair either.
I do.
Oh, you do? Oh.
She said I do.
Oh, okay. So what color?
You know, me being a religious person, I say red for, like, the blood of Jesus.
Go ahead, girl. Fire!
That's a good one, but it's not going to happen.
I never really thought about dyeing my hair, but if I could, I would dye it.
You don't know.
Blue.
Blue? Why?
I just like the color blue. So.
You like the color blue.
Okay,
that's good. We have to find out. I know there's a ribbon that's... Do you know what the color of anti-bullying is?
Well, the colors are purple and green.
Purple and green.
That's the original color of the bracelets.
Okay, purple and green for anti-bullying. We had a great time with Little Miss Bria Huff and Damali Morgan Bean and wonderful young ladies. We want to express our gratitude for having them here. Thank you so much to our co-host,
Arnell Morgan Bean.
Yes, we had a great time.
Wonderful
Girl power, girl power. Yes. Tune in next Tuesday right here at Vessel Radio, 7 p.m. I enjoyed you guys. Remember to be a vessel. Any closing words, Shazan?
No, and once again, we appreciate you guys tuning in. Be sure to spread the word to all of your family and friends. Check us out each and every Tuesday, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, sharp here at Vessel Radio. Be sure to also send us your comments to vesselradio@gmail.com. And as always, we need you guys to continue to follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Vessel Radio. God bless. Have a wonderful, blessed, and prosperous week. See you next week.
Ministry over industry. The best. Ministry over industry, the best.